year after the Beatles was like, but I mean, it made me sympathise with people on the dole, because people said on the, you'd hear people saying, well, you know, it's not so much just not having a job anymore, it's the feeling useless that's the thing. And that's how I felt. I felt like I didn't have a use anymore. You know, I'd been one of the Beatles, I'd been a bass player, and I'd been a co-writer with John. Suddenly all that was taken away. And I just thought, well, am I any good on my own?
So, you know, Linda was there on keyboards, terrified out of her mind all the time. That's about the craziest thing you can do, bring in your wife who's not had any previous musical experience. Well, you know, people couldn't accept that just we wanted to go back to square one and just become a little skiffle group again. And we were back at that stage. But it was the only thing I could think of to do, you know, and I thought I was doing just what I knew how to do.
So we went on the road. Boy, did we go on the road.
Tell us about it.
I mean, well, because the thing is, you know, normally you go on the road, at least you book hotels. You know, anyone books hotels. But we decided to really just busk the whole thing. So we had a tranny, and we just headed off up the motorway. We had the kids, a couple of dogs, the whole group, all our instruments. Oh, there was a U-Haul following behind with the
the roadies.
Yeah. The roadies, yeah. And we literally turned up at universities and stuff. We turned up at Nottingham University, was the first one. And we said, in fact, we didn't. I didn't say anything. I stayed in the van. couldn't handle it. One of the lads, Ian Horn, actually, went in and said, well, you know, I've got Paul McCartney out in the van. I mean, do you want him on the lunchtime tomorrow? And the students, you know, yes, off, you know, get out of here. Really? You know, and they come out in the van to sort of check. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we love him. So we played that next lunch hour. 50p on the door. Reasonable. It was quite funny because we didn't know that many numbers. We were a very new band. And I think we had something like 11 numbers.
Thank you. Well, thank you, darling. You're a The devil's everywhere. Thank you. Thank you. one more song. We haven't rehearsed this one.
Yeah. Over there on the guitar is Henry McCullough. Thank you. then this match one will be the end of the third bit we're doing, then we'll take a little break. This one is up on next LP. Up on next LP. And it's called The Mess I'm In. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
few. We haven't got many numbers together, you know. So, as I said earlier, there is that. Thank you. So we're going to repeat the song, which is the one that's been banned by the BBC already before it's even happened. So don't hear it on the BBC, you probably won't hear it, but it's released next week anyway, the single. So give Ireland back to the Irish. Thank you. Sorry, but that's out next week, so if you like it, you can buy it. But you want to hear it on TV6.
Oh,
I'd
like it in birth.
And it's not that political or anything, really, you know. Okay, we're going to repeat another one, too. This is one we played earlier. It's going to be our next song called The Best I'm In.
Thank you.